Welcome to Mrigashira, a podcast that communicates with communicators. This podcast is a tribute to our fantastic fellow professionals, colleagues and friends. I'm Charu Raizada and this podcast is brought to you in association with DigiTales. You know how there are some companies we look at, admire and say, wow, I'd really like to work there. Those companies have a good sense of what employees are looking for and truly know how to engage with existing talent and attract potential talent. As the lines blur even more between marketing and recruitment, an insight into company culture, career progression, and colleagues is now a must for job seekers. We caught up with Bhaskar Majumdar, Head Corporate Affairs, Communication and Digital, Aegis India, to know more about his award-winning program, which explored multiple digital and offline channels to ensure that the engineering teams and staff of Aegis spread across the country were safe, connected, engaged during COVID. In this episode of Megashira, a podcast for communication folks, Bhaskar talks about his experiences in creating a strong employer brand for B2B companies. Stay with us. Hello and welcome to Mrigashira, Bhaskar. Congratulations for continuously inspiring us with award-winning work. And on today's episode, we hope to learn a lot more about some of your campaigns.
Thanks a lot. And I'm happy to be here.
I'm going to step back and ask you, when you moved to Aegis, which is a B2B company, what were your topmost challenges?
So actually, it's multiple. You know, as you said, first, it's a B2B company that in engineering consulting space. I mean, even though the brand is involved in more than, say, 8-9 metros, 3 airports, ports, dams, and multiple other infrastructure projects. But still, as a brand, it's not known beyond the industry. I mean, when I say industry, it's more of the engineering space. And even in engineering, it's more of consulting, right? So in engineering, you may have heard of L&T, Lanco, and other companies. But Aegis as a company, which is more into consulting space, was not very much well known. And when you have to work for a brand which has to be, you know, highlighted in front of stakeholders or created some kind of awareness about your work, and the channels are very limited because 100% of our clients are government clients. So there is always this issue of you've been able to talk about a particular project or not. So multiple issues were there, but within 3 months, I was been able to, you know, manage it well, starting from India website to social media presence, to increase visibility in media, along with other key stakeholders. I think COVID has actually helped in a way of, you know, creating the visibility, because social media was a key component of, you know, making the brand visible. So I will not say challenges, but yes, as you said, B2B company has its own issues.
No, of course. And I think the best thing is about COVID is that there's always an opportunity, and that has helped the B2B companies specifically transition towards the power of social, power of digital, and looking at new ways and new solutions. Typically for a consumer-centric brand or business, the dynamics are always different when it comes to attracting talent. What does it take to create a strong employer brand for a B2B company?
See, again, you know, I think it has changed. Pre-COVID arena, it was completely different. And post-COVID or during COVID arena, it's completely different. Nowadays, I think young talent, especially we are an engineering company, so we 80% of our work strength is engineers, and they are below age of 35. Their requirements are very different. The post-COVID era or during COVID era also, key factors which matters for new talent to come and join a company like us was flexibility at work-life balance, kind of job security. When I say not only job security, it's kind of security, creative work, and most importantly, you know, international exposure. So you are a French company, almost present in 100 companies, and there is always this possibility of Indian employees working for, you know, international projects. Especially, you know, recently we have opened up a small unit, which is kind of a design center. And And generally, the design center work is mostly with the work which is ongoing abroad, not the Indian work. So I think international exposure is something which is very much required for engineers to look for a new brand. And I think social media helped us a lot in that, because whenever you're doing any creative work, it was easy for us to talk to our audience, especially the prospective employees, to communicate and to tell what kind of work we are doing and how we are different from the other competitors.
So here you've talked about that their needs are different and it's a younger people. But, when it comes to communicating about your employer brand to the external world to attract this talent, what kind of approach works best? Some people prefer bold and authentic. They like sharing what's really like to work at the company. What exactly are candidates really looking for these days?
So during COVID time, it was very important to engage with internal audience as well as external audience. When I say internal audience, it's mostly to do with employees. And when I say external audience, it can be any of the stakeholders, especially the budding engineers or budding employees who are looking for a job. I think the critical part for any brand is to communicate the flexibility at work, work-life balance, the kind of security you give to your employees is very much important. Like case in point, I've seen, a lot of companies who have started, online yoga or virtual, challenges, which I think in a way is a very good way to, engage with, not only with the employees, also with their family. And I think days are gone when people used to go for big brands. Now people are more inclined to go to brand which actually thinks for them, thinks for their family and stands for their family. So when I say security, it's not only job security, it's kind of all kinds of securities. There are families, there are employees who have aged parents at home, they have in-laws at home, and insecurity about their health, insecurity of not getting medicine on time or not getting proper medical facility on time is also critical. As I said, mental health has become a key thing for every company. And I think it's very much important for every brand who's trying to communicate it with all stakeholders, especially with internal and external employees. These are key things one should keep in their mind.
You've explored multiple digital and offline channels to ensure that the engineering teams and staff of ages spread across the country, they stay connected and engaged. Tell us more about how you have integrated digital in your communication campaigns for employees.
So we verify initial stages where I actually joined the company and lockdown was yet to happen. Most of the engagement used to happen one-to-one or people used to visit site offices. We have got almost 3,000 employees nationally, and our corporate office has got only 300 people, and almost 27 to 2,800 people are scattered in various site offices. It can be in Bombay, it can be Pune, it can be remote areas in Arunachal also. And it became very, very important that, you engage with your employees, because most of the employees are actually, staying away from home. And during lockdown or during COVID time, this insecure thought of how my family is or how I'm going to, cope up with work, also not being able to go to office on a regular basis as earlier as used to do, has given us a lot of, complications. So we thought of, engaging them on a regular basis and in a consistent way. And along with HR, we devised a lot of, activities. And because of COVID and as COVID has, fast-forwarded the digital transformation, a digital way of connecting was the only way which was possible, because there were restrictions on travel and there were multiple restrictions. So we devised a umbrella campaign and under that campaign, there were multiple things. One of the campaign I can talk about, we thought, how to encourage people to take up, physical activity. So we started a small activity and in WhatsApp groups, we started giving some kind of challenges to the employees. And it can be running, it can be walking, it can be cycling. And we started one group in Strava also. So initial stages of first 2 weeks, the attendance was not very encouraging from the employee side. But slowly, after 1 month, there's something around 1,000 people who participated. So I think every brand has to engage with their employees and give that kind of feeling that we are also there for you. So I'll give you two examples. One was this, walking, running and other physical activities which we tried to do. Second was multiple small breakup campaigns like, virtual yoga. And I'll give you one example. One of my colleague, he was regular in the yoga session, but he was not very much, you know, involved in yoga. So I asked him, he said, you know, the only reason I'm connecting in yoga session is to, you know, see the faces of my other colleagues, which I've not been able to see in last 6 months of time. Right. Now that was something which was, you know, very touching. Then one guy said, you know, that, you know, can my family members, my parents, my wife, they can also join the yoga session. Now, then we understood that by these sessions, you are not only connecting with the employees, you are actually connecting with a larger audience, with the family also. Right. So that was one activity. Then there was a, you know, painting competition for kids. So there were multiple ways to engage not only that particular employee, also each and every member of his family, like right. starting from kids to his wife, to the employees, maybe even parents. So we tied up with a few institutions, I'll not name them. And these institutions were like, you know, giving some kind of facilities to people who were 60 plus, you know, doctor on call or medicine to be sent at home. Now, maybe these are very small things, but for the employee who has got his aged parents or in-laws staying with him, it eases a lot of his tension, right? And that security for life or security for the well-being of his family members increases. So multiple things, but we tried touching up all the family members so that, you know, there is a positive environment and less of, you know, insecurity at home.
Companies engaging with their employees, can that have a large difference on the success or the failure of the company?
Of course. See, I mean, you always need happy employees to work for the brand, you know. But if the employees start feeling that it's just a job and it's a 9-to-5 job, maybe the creative way of working may not, you know, arise. So it's always good to have happy employees who feel good to be associated with the brand. And not only the employee, their family members also think positive things about that particular brand. And that is going to be key in days to come, because, you know, it's not only about one particular employee, it's about their family also. And okay. The close connect with the family helps a lot to ease out a lot of tensions at their end as well as the brand's end also. And as I said that, you know, during COVID time, there is another very important thing that, you know, teamwork has given reason to a lot of creativity. As I said, you know, creativity is, you know, the best way out of any kind of crisis. And one can be creative only when he is happy about working on a particular project or any particular brand.
So you've talked about programs using digital internally to bond employees. What about programs or digital programs you could do to attract talent? Communicating externally using digital to attract talent.
So there are multiple things we have done. We have run certain campaigns. I'm not going to elaborate on them. It's more of how creative you are, how challenging your work can be. And people can come and participate, especially the budding engineers can come and participate. And we had a internal jury who is going to, you know, evaluate their kind of work. So these kind of smaller things can actually help people to know about your brand and also about the kind of projects you're doing on or the kind of work you're doing on. Because, you know, apart from a certain section of you know, people who are going to join for a particular brand, the other people may not know much about the brand. So that's, I think, the best way to, you know, be vocal and talk about your brand is one way to, you know, engage with the external audience who you think will be probable, you know, employees for your company. And also to create subcommittees inside the company and have brand champions who are already working with Aegis. So maybe someone from the engineering team can talk about his experience or his creativity which he has done in his work, and that may be something which can be, you know, inspiring from people who can take the lead and come and join that particular brand. I think it has to be two ways. One, external audience. For external audience, there has to be certain campaigns to engage with them. Also, you have to create brand champions inside who can be vocal and who can actually advocate about your brand.
Right. So just last question, in three words, describe a well-crafted strategy for a strong employer brand.
I think, again, it has changed. Flexibility, authenticity, clarity and trust are, I think, the three key pillars for any company to, you know, to work for either internal audience or for the external audience. See, we have to be, you know, flexible, patient and understanding with all stakeholders, especially with employees. And somehow, you know, The communication should be more transparent, empathetic, proactive, and it has to be consistent, because kind of, you know, engagement once in a quarter is not going to work. It has to be almost on a weekly basis. Unless you're consistent on your messaging and you're saying that as a brand, we are with you, it's very difficult to create a, you know, positive environment.
Agree with you completely. And thank you so much for sharing, you know, some of your experiences with us. And I'm sure there's a lot of people will benefit out of them.
Thanks a lot, Charu. And I'm happy to be here. Thanks.
Hope you enjoy listening to Mrigashira, a podcast for communication folks. Do share your suggestions and feedback on mrigashira@digitales.co.in. Have a great week ahead, and do not forget to tune in next week. Adios.